remember during power failures at my grandmother's house, we all had to say something. A little poem, a joke, a fact about the world. How about telling each other something we've never told before? Okay, I'll start. The first time I was alone in your apartment, I looked in your address book to see if you'd written me in. I think we'd known each other about 2 weeks. Now it's your turn. It's a
still life watercolor. The first time we went out to dinner to the Portuguese place, I forgot to tip the waiter. I went back the next morning, found out his name, left money with the manager.
That time when your mother came to visit us, when I said one night that I had to stay late at work, I actually went out with Jillian and had a martini.
I cheated on my Oriental Civilization exam in college. I could see the blue book of the guy next to me. I looked at his answer and copied it down. And you read your Emily Dickinson, and I my Robert Frost, and we note our place with bookmarkers that measure what we've lost. Like a poem poorly written, we are verses out of rhythm, couplets out of rhyme, in syncopated time, and the dangling conversation.
I've been looking for an apartment and I found one.
Our baby was a boy. His skin was more red than brown. He had black hair on his head. He weighed almost 5 pounds. His fingers were curled shut, just like yours in the night. Can analysis be worthwhile? Is the theater really dead? And how the room is softly faded. And I only kiss your shadow. I cannot feel your hand. You're a stranger now unto me. Lost in the dangling conversation and the superficial sighs in the borders of our lives.